The Immigration Bureau says it has uncovered a human trafficking ring that recruits victims for prostitution. Last week, authorities rescued two Filipino victims who were illegally recruited to work as entertainers abroad. Other victims of the ring were detained and forced into prostitution. Meanwhile, the Immigration Bureau defending the revised departure rules for Filipino travelers. The new policy comes as government ramps up efforts to combat human trafficking.
Ang tinitingnan talaga natin is the purpose of travel. If the purpose of travel is in connection dun sa dokumento na pinapakita nila, wala pong problema. Even first-time travelers, hindi po necessary na first-time travelers ay mas mahigpit po tayo o mas mabusisi tayo doon sa gagawin ng tao. Kung makita po ng immigration officers na legitimate travel, wala pong tinatago, hindi po nagsisinungaling yung tao, wala pong magiging problema.
The chairperson of the Senate Committee on Justice and Human Rights bats for the creation of an office tasked with ensuring the welfare of household helpers. Senator Frances Tolentino says while the Domestic Workers Act is good on paper, there are gaps when it comes to its implementation. The Senate recently opened an investigation into the alleged severe maltreatment of a household helper in Occidental Mindoro.
The law is very specific on this. The problem is that the monitoring system is not in place. We really made focus before on our OFWs, working abroad, domestic helpers. Perhaps there should be a local version of this, a local bureau or agency in charge of domestic helpers, not just for purposes of hotlines, but for purposes of really educating not just the domestic workers themselves, but the employers on their responsibilities. There should likewise be a special court to handle cases involving domestic helpers.
Senator Tolentino, meanwhile, sees a long process ahead in reforming the country's prison system. Issues in the national penitentiary again came to light following the escape of an inmate from the maximum security compound of the New Bilibid prisons. The inmate, Michael Cataroja, was subsequently recaptured.
Marami pa hong gagawin doon. And I think prison reforms probably might not just be reflective of symptoms of our judicial justice system, but society at large. The bottom line here is how can a person tightly guarded in a national maximum security compound be able to accomplish all of this with all the security and protective measures in place? So that's the reason why I said perhaps he might be in cahoots with some guards or officials there, because you cannot really do that. Nung pinasakay namin siya sa ilalim, after 5 minutes, nainita na siya.
The Ombudsman has approved the filing of graft charges against former officials of the Procurement Service of the Budget Department linked to the multi-billion peso formally controversy. Our very own Adrian Ayelena joins us with details. Adrian, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, the Office of the Ombudsman has recommended the filing of 3 counts of graft against 3 former officials of the Procurement Service, Department of Budget and Management, for their involvement in the 4.165 billion peso COVID-19 test kits contract with Pharmaly Pharmaceutical Corporation. In the resolution of the Ombudsman dated August 14, 2023, former PSDBM Executive Director Lloyd Christopher Lau, former Procurement Group Director Warren Rex Leong, who is now serving as overall Deputy Ombudsman, and former Procurement Management Officer Paul Jasper de Guzman caused undue injury to the government in the total amount of 4 billion pesos. The Ombudsman also recommended the filing of graft charges against private respondents and formerly executives Twinkle Dargani, Mohit Dargani, Lincoln Ong, Justin Garrado, and Huang Tzu-Yen. The resolution was approved by Ombudsman Samuel Martirez on August 18, 2023. 3 tranches of contracts entered into with Pharmaly for RT-PCR kits amounting to 600 million, 688 million, and 2.8 billion pesos were mentioned in the resolution. The Ombudsman noted that the former officials favored Pharmaly over one top medical systems resources, which offered the same prices, as well as BioSite Medical Instruments Incorporated, which is one of the suppliers included in the Suppliers Directory for the Bayanihan Act. The investigation of the ombudsman stemmed from the complaint filed by former Senator Richard Gordon and Senator Rita Ontiveros, who both conducted thorough inquiries at the Senate. The three former PSDBM officials, as well as former Procurement Management Officer Webster Laureniana, were also held administratively liable as they were found guilty of grave misconduct, gross neglect of duty, serious dishonesty, and conduct prejudicial to the best interests of the service. The ombudsman ordered their dismissal from government service, forfeiture of retirement benefits, and perpetual disqualification in government. The ombudsman noted in the decision that Lau signed the three notices of award and contract agreements, all dated April 22, 2020, in favor of Farmally. Lau and Leong also signed the price analysis report, which was prepared by De Guzman. The ombudsman said in the resolution that there is no doubt that without the individual acts of the respondents, the procurement of the test kits would not have materialized.
Cagayan de Oro Representative Rufus Rodriguez defending the Universal Access to Quality Tertiary Education Act. See, Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno earlier said the measure, touted as one of the legacies of the Duterte administration, is unsustainable and even anti-poor. But Rodriguez says providing quality education to Filipino students should be prioritized by government. He adds, Diokno's position on the matter is untenable.
Government is for the people, by the people and of the people. If we are going to do this, scrap this, then what happens to the 2 million students? Yeah. Because the budget for all the country for 2 million students is only 51.1 billion. How much is that to our budget of 5.7 trillion? Less than 1%. And less than 1%. Mm-mm. In fact, infrastructure is 890 billion. Mm-mm. This is only 51 billion to have education that emancipates the poor from the bondage of poverty.
Then we have this just in. The operator of the tsunami-hit Fukushima nuclear power plant has begun releasing its first batch of treated radioactive water into the Pacific Ocean. The plant will release over 1 million metric tons of radioactive wastewater over a period of 30 years after Japan got the green light from the International Atomic Energy Agency back in July. China and South Korea are among several countries that have voiced strong opposition to Japan's move, citing possible environmental effects and the danger it poses to public health. Is Japan set to begin disposing treated nuclear water into the Pacific Ocean today? Japan will release over 1 million metric tons of treated radioactive water from its tsunami-hit Fukushima nuclear plant after it got the green light from the International Atomic Energy Agency back in July. The discharge is expected to last for about 30 years. Several nations are slamming Japan's move, including neighboring China, which has already imposed a seafood ban on Fukushima and other Japanese prefectures.
China strongly urges Japan to revoke its wrong decision. Stop pushing ahead with the nuclear contaminated water discharge plan, communicate with its neighbors sincerely, and handle the matter in a responsible manner so as to avoid causing unpredictable damage and harm to the global marine environment. If Japan sticks to the plan, the Chinese government will take necessary measures to firmly safeguard its marine environment, food safety, and public health. Water spilled on the ground cannot be gathered up again. We do not want August 24, 2023 to be the disaster day for marine environment. If Japan persists, it must bear historical responsibility for this.
The Philippine government, for its part, says it is looking at the issue from a science and fact-based perspective and its impact on the waters in the region. The Foreign Affairs Department adds government recognizes the technical expertise of the IAEA on the matter. Several organizations, including Philippine Fisher Folk Group Pamalakaya, also raising the alarm over the looming release of Fukushima's wastewater. Pamalakaya warns this move endangers Philippine waters, which will severely affect the livelihood of fishermen. The Philippine government's top economist believes it will take a lot of time and effort before the country enjoys cheaper rice prices. At least one senator believes an artificial shortage is driving up the cost of the staple grain. More from Jervis Manahan.
National Economic and Development Authority, or NEDA, admits cheaper rice prices won't happen overnight. NEDA says massive investments have to be made to increase rice productivity, including the introduction of newer technology in irrigation, modern rice varieties, and pest control. The statement comes after officials of the Agriculture Department admitted in their budget hearing on Tuesday that there is no roadmap yet to bring down the price of rice to 20 pesos per kilo.
Our position has always been that we need to increase productivity in agriculture. All right. What drives low prices are increases in productivity. We are not in control of so many things, no? Assuming that we progressed in raising productivity, you should be able to increase the purchasing power.
Senator Cynthia Villar, chairperson of the Senate Committee on Agriculture and Food, believes the spike in prices is due to an artificial shortage.
Wala pa naman shortage eh, but tumataas na. They foresee a shortage, but we don't know yet because they're going to harvest September to November. Di pa natin alam kung ilang iha-harvest, but nagsasabi silang may shortage.
Meanwhile, Agriculture Group Sinag formally wrote to President Bongbong Marcos to reiterate their call to abolish the National Food Authority. The group says the agency has failed to fulfill its mandate, which has led to rising rice prices.
As an agency, hindi nila ginawa yung mandate nila na bumili ng palay. So yun ang bottom line dyan. Dapat bumili silang palay sa ating mga magsasaka.
Cheaper rice at 38 pesos per kilo is still being sold in various parts of the country, thanks to the initiative of the Philippine Rice Industry Stakeholders Movement, or PRISM. However, it's hit or miss for many consumers since supply usually runs out fast.
Sa bigas lang, naghahanap po kami ng mga 30 man lang mahigit. Eh kaso puro na mga matataas ang bilihin ngayon. Hirap talaga, lalo na kung ang hanap buhay mo, maliit lang sinasahod.
Consumers admit it's difficult to make ends meet due to high commodity prices, including rice. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.